Dear students, myself Dr. Fatima Sultana, Associate Professor in Department of Zoology, JDB Government Girls College, Kota. Today I am going to complete your chapter Biogeographical Realms. We all know that there are 8 biogeographical realms, and biogeographical realms are large spatial regions of Earth's land surface. Till date we have completed 4 realms: Nearctic realm, Palearctic realm, Neotropical realm and Afrotropic realm. Today we are going to take Indo-Malayan realm, Australasia realm, Oceanic realm and Antarctic realm. Indo-Malayan biogeographical realm, it includes the Indian subcontinent, Southeast Asia and Southern China. The area being shown in dark purple color in this map, you can see the Indo-Malayan realm. Indo-Malayan realm, it is also known as Oriental realm. The area covered in this realm is 7.5 million square kilometers. It includes the Indian subcontinent, Southeast Asia and Southern China. Thus, it includes regions such as Afghanistan through the Indian subcontinent, lowland Southern China, Indonesia, Philippines, lowland Taiwan and Japan's Ryukyu Islands. World Wildlife Fund, WWF, has suggested 3 major bioregions in this Indo-Malayan realm. You can see the different colors in this, green color, yellow color and light yellow color. The Indian subcontinent bioregion, the Indochina bioregion and the Sunda Shelf and the ecological regions of Philippines. The Indo-Malayan realm is one of the 8 biogeographic realms. It extends across most of south. In south, we can see that the region consists of Afghanistan, Bangladesh, Bhutan, India, the Maldives, Nepal, Pakistan and Sri Lanka. And Southeast Asia. Southeast Asia, it's geographically, the regions in this area comes south of China, east of the Indian subcontinent and northwest of Australia. Southeast Asia border is border to the north of East Asia, to the way by South Asia and the Bay of Bengal. This is the Southeast Asia, the region shown in dark green color. Then the area comes of the southern parts of East Asia. In East Asia, it consists of the modern states of East Asia include China, Hong Kong, Japan, Macau, Mongolia, North Korea, South Korea and Taiwan. Now, as I have told you that Indo-Malayan realm is also known as the Oriental realm by many biogeographers. Indo-Malaya spreads all over the Indian subcontinent and Southeast Asia to lowland Southern China and through Indonesia as far as Java, Bali and Borneo, east of which lies the Wallace line. The realm boundary named after Alfred Russel Wallace, it separates Indo-Malayan region from the Australian biogeographical realm. This line of Wallace, which was given the name after Alfred Russel Wallace, it acts as the biogeographical line or partition between the Indo-Malayan and Australian realm. The Indo-Malayan also includes the Philippines, lowland Taiwan and Japan's Ryukyu Islands. Most of Indo-Malaya was originally covered by forest, mostly tropical and subtropical moist broadleaf forest. This is when we were discussing about the neotropical biogeographical realm, I said that the majority of the tropical and subtropical moist broadleaf forest was covered in the neotropical realm. But the second largest comes under this Indo-Malayan realm. We can see in green color on the left side of this map, tropical and subtropical moist broadleaf forest. And on the right side, you can see the tropical and subtropical dry broadleaf forest. which predominates in much of India and parts of Southeast Asia. The tropical moist forest of Indomalaya are mostly dominated by trees of Diptocarp. Diptocarps, in this figure you can see photo, the fruit, it is very important and distinguishing character of this is that the splitting of that fruit. Diptocarps are characteristic trees of Indomalaya's moist and seasonally dry forest, with the greatest species of diversity in moist forest of Borneo. Teak is characteristic of the seasonally dry forest of the Indomalaya, from India through Indochina, Malaysia and the Philippines. Tropical pitcher plants. Pitcher plant is shown in this photo. We all know what is pitcher plant. It traps the insects. And it is also characteristic of Indomalaya, and the greatest diversity of species is in Sumatra, Borneo and the Philippines. Now, fauna is also very good in this Indomalayan region. Two orders of mammals, the colugas and tree shrews, are endemic to the realm, as are families of Crassiniteridia, Kitty's long nose bat. This Kitty's long nose bat is the smallest bat. You can see in this photo, the bat is lying on only one finger, index finger. So it is very small, smallest bat in the world. Next are the other large mammals characteristic of Indomalaya that include leopard, tigers, water buffaloes, Asian elephant, Indian rhinoceros, Javan rhinoceros, Malayan tapir, orangutans and gibbons. Indomalaya has three endemic bird families. The Eirinidia, in which these fairy bluebirds come, Megalemnidia, in which Asian barbets are there, and Rhabdotanidia, which consists of Philippine creepers. They are also characteristics. Other characteristic birds of this Indomalayan realm are pheasants, petas, old world babblers, and flower peckers. The Indomalaya has 1,000 species of amphibians in 81 genera, about 17 of global species. 800 Indomalayan species, or you can say that 80% are endemic. So we see that there are a good diversity of flora as well as the fauna found in the Indomalayan realm. It is the one of the important hotspot biodiversity region. Next comes the Australasia biogeographical realm. A biogeographical realm that covers Australia, New Guinea, New Zealand and neighboring islands. The Australasia realm, it consists of the area of 7.6 million square kilometers. It includes Australia, New Guinea, New Zealand, eastern of Indonesian archipelago, Bismarck, Vanuatu and the Solomon Islands and New Caledonia. This realm shares similar flora with Antarctic realm. Nevertheless, the northern tropical islands share similar flora with the Southeast Asia. As I have told you, the Wallace line, about the Wallace line, this serves as the biological dividing line from the Indomalayan realm of the tropical Asia. This boundary, named after the British naturalist Alfred Russel Wallace, acts as the transitional zone between Asia and Australia. This is the Australia biogeographical realm among the eight realms. Here in red you can see the Wallace line. What I have told you previously also, that this divides the Indomalayan realm from the Australia. Ecoregions of the Australian realm the color coded biome you can see in this map. Dark green color shows the tropical and subtropical moist broadleaf forest. Light brown, tropical and subtropical dry broadleaf forest. And yellow color shows tropical and subtropical grasslands, savannas and shrublands. Green, light green color, temperate broadleaf and mixed forest. And similarly, the temperate grasslands, savannas, flooded grasslands, mountain grasslands. Australia is known for the beautiful grasslands. Next comes the ocean in biogeographical realm. A biogeographical realm that covers Polynesia, Micronesia and the Fijian Islands. It includes Polynesia, except New Zealand, Micronesia and the Fijian Islands. It does not include continental landmass, but the islands of Pacific Ocean such as Micronesia, Fijian Islands, Hawaiian Islands and Polynesia. The oceanic realm is regarded as one of the smallest realm in terms of land area and also the youngest realm. It includes the volcanic high islands and coral atolls. The oceanic biorealm covers a total area of 0.39 million square miles, making it the second smallest of all the realm. When we were discussing previously, we came to know which was the largest biogeographical realm, Palearctic. And now this oceanic biogeographic, it is the second smallest of all the realms. But if we speak in terms of land, it will be the first. It is comprised of a number of islands, including the US state of Hawaii, a part of Japan, the John Fernandez Islands, the Cocos Islands, and the Campbell Islands. These are the few. Otherwise, the oceanic biogeographical realm, it is actually having tidbits of islands, not a whole coverage of land, rather in the form of small islands. Although it covers a larger area than the Antarctic realm, Oceania actually has the smallest land area of all the biogeographical realms on Earth. It has a permanent human population of over 40 million individuals. Geographically, Oceania is known for its large amounts of coral reef, the most famous of which is the Great Barrier Reef. Now, in this blue line, within this blue line, in the ocean, we can see the Oceanian realm, in which only bits of islands you can see. It is sparsely distributed here and there in this realm. Therefore, we say in terms of land, if we speak, it has very less land area. Oceania is geologically the youngest realm, while other realms include old continental land masses or fragments of continents. Youngest realm means it developed very later in the age. The Oceania is composed mostly of volcanic highlands, high islands and coral atolls that arose from the sea in geologically recent times. Many of them in the Pleistocene time. They were created either by hotspot volcanism or as islands arcs pushed upward by the collision and subduction of tectonic plates. As I have told you that this realm is the geologically youngest realm. So how it could form? Either by the eruption of volcanoes, the land was formed, or by the collision and subduction of the tectonic plates, the land came up. The island range from tiny islets, sea stacks and coral atolls to large mountainous islands like Hawaii and Fiji. We can see this area, Hawaii and Fiji, in which the land has been come up in the form of islands. As I have told that this area, this realm has volcanoes and coral atolls. So this is very beautiful area in which it promotes tourism. Flora and fauna. Since the island of Oceania were never connected by land to a continent. As I have told you that in terms of land, if we speak, they are spread in the form of small islands. So we see that they were never connected by land to a continent. So the flora and fauna of the islands originally reached them from across the ocean. Once they reached the islands, the ancestors of Oceania present flora and fauna adapted to life on the islands. Now, when the flora and fauna, for example, if we speak of flora, the coconut plants, because we know that coconut can drift on the salty water and it can reach easily from one place to another place and gets implanted. So in this form we see that when this flora and fauna, the seeds flown by the wind reach this has reached the islands. Now when they reached these islands, they got adapted, and due to adaptations we can see the various things like gigantism, yani that large, the size of the for animals has increased, or the birds, their nature has been changed because they have adapted themselves according to the islands, islands ecology. So we see that once they reached the islands, the ancestors of the Oceania present flora and fauna adapted to life. Now, larger islands with diverse ecological niches encouraged floral and faunal adaptive radiation, whereby multiple species evolved from a common ancestor. So now we see that because of this adaptive radiation, multiple species have evolved. Each species adapted to a different ecological niche, and the various species of Hawaiian honey creepers are a classical example of such adaptive radiations. So other adaptations, as I have told you, in the while adapting to the various ecology of that area, that includes gigantism, dwarfism, and among birds most important is that loss of flight. They slowly adapted and got accustomed to that, acclimatized to that area, and they lost the flight mode. Oceania has a number of endemic species, and Hawaii in particular is considered a global center of endemism, with its forest ecoregions having one of the highest percentage of endemic plants in the world. Lizards are very important in this area because they have well adapted and they have evolved into many different species type. Next comes the Antarctic biogeographic realm. This realm covers a total area of 0.12 million square miles, making it the smallest of all the realms. The Antarctic biogeographic region is located in the southern ocean and is comprised of the area surrounding the South Pole, including Antarctica, the islands above the Antarctic tectonic plate, the ice in the water, and ocean itself. So as whenever we listen to the word Antarctic, the image which comes in our mind is that fully covered by ice. All of these different components make up 20% of the southern hemisphere. The surroundings of the South Pole, including the Antarctica, the islands above the Antarctic tectonic plate, the ice in the water and the ocean itself. This all forms the 20% of the southern hemisphere. So because of freezing temperatures here, just under 1% of Antarctic is usually exposed land. Only of all the area of 0.12 million square miles, only 1% is exposed land. Otherwise, it is fully covered by ice. The blue region shown in the southern hemisphere is the Antarctic. As we can see that this realm is totally covered by ice. And only the exposed land is 1%. This realm is home to plant species such as lichens, mosses, Antarctic hair grass and microfungi. Additionally, some animal species may be found here, and that depends upon the time of the year. These are well adapted for cold temperature because in Antarctic region we can see temperatures as below as minus 25 degrees. These animal species include penguins, whales, squid, albatross, seals and Antarctic petrels. Antarctic petrels are birds found in this area. Thank you so much. You all might have gone through all the 8 biogeographical realms. Kindly go through this chapter.